Welcome back to Fox and Friends. First, could having easier access to marijuana help the nationwide opioid crisis? Well, according to some new studies published by the American Medical Association, researchers found that 14% reduction in opioid prescriptions in states that allow medical marijuana. So is legal weed really the solution? Here now to talk about it is Fox News contributor Dr. Marc Siegel. We always love having you with us.
Good to see you this morning, Heather.
So what do you think about this study?
Well, okay, so there's two studies, both of them published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, one out of Georgia, one out of Kentucky, and they show that if we prescribe marijuana for chronic pain, for pain in the nerves, problems with pain from other diseases, the chances that I would reach for the pen and prescribe opioids is less. I believe that. I believe that the chances of prescribing opioids is less if you're going to prescribe marijuana.
From the doctor,
if you're
in a state where it's legal.
Right, exactly. Okay. And that's 29 states and District of Columbia currently.
We can actually pull those up, I think.
Right, 29 those. District of Columbia. But that's not the same thing as saying, you know, mainstream media trying to draw a message from this, oh, let's legalize it across the board, recreational use. The problem with recreational use of marijuana is that you're three times more likely to end up on heroin, according to the Centers for Disease Control.
Because it can be a gateway drug.
Now, it is a gateway drug.
Before you get into that, let's pull up these facts by the numbers, because it is a fact what Dr. Marc Siegel is talking about. 64,000 Americans were killed by drug overdoses in 2016, a 21.5% spike in overdose deaths in 2016. But then, according to the CDC, what you were just talking about, 3.7 million fewer daily doses of opioids were filled in states with pot dispensaries where it's legal. That being, again, as you said, by doctors.
Right. Now, I also want doctors out there to say, what am I prescribing it for? Because a lot of times we're calling something chronic pain that isn't chronic pain. What's the problem? You know, why do you have your back pain?
Right.
Is it muscle spasm? Could I give you a muscle relaxer? Could you use physical therapy, heat, acupuncture, chiropractic? There's a lot of possible things that one could use before you even were to turn to marijuana. But in chronic pain use, marijuana has a role. I believe in that. I believe in medical use for that.
But the recreational use is the issue.
It's completely different, and because marijuana has long-term side effects as well. It interferes with thinking. It interferes with behavior. We talked on this show about pregnant women using it, which is horrendous for fetuses. So you have to figure out why you're using it, and a doctor has to be in the loop on this. Recreational use is definitely a gateway drug for heroin.
All right.
So again, and also, it's only specific types of opioids that decrease. In other words, if I prescribe marijuana for pain, I'm less likely to prescribe Vicodin. I'm less likely to prescribe fentanyl. Fentanyl is a big ticket item right now, Heather, because fentanyl use leads to illicit fentanyl use, which is very powerful, and that's leading to the overdoses.
Yeah.
That's a really bad one out there
so
right now.
So you can't just take a look at the headline of the study. You have to actually take a look at what's in it.
Beneath the headline is doctors can prescribe it for pain instead of opioids. Yes. Recreational use leads to heroin use.
No. Okay. Thank you so
Good
much, Dr. Siegel.
Great
Nicely said.